Back with another figure kit. Now, you know I love these diorama slash figure kits from Polar Lights, the Pirates, now the Haunted Mansion model kit series, Flight of the Vampire. Check that out. He's got motion activation. The head comes off the headstone. We got a little diorama base. It's all in 12th scale, so it's a nice size. Molded completely in glow-in-the-dark plastic, if you want to leave it that way. They give you a full paint guide on the back. They don't name the paints, but come on. They give you a full completed picture of the model so you can detail it as you wish. Explains all the motion, and it doesn't require any batteries. So let's look at all the stuff that'll be in the kit when you get yours. I'll throw some glow-in-the-dark trees out on the table. We got some loose parts in the bag. We got the back of a skull. We got the halves of the angel or goat or demon head, whatever you want to call that. Feel free to call it anything you want. I call it spooky. So that's pretty cool. That's on the headstone there. We've got part of his cape for the vampire. We've got a motion switch here. I always can tell this is part of the motion activation on the model. Now on this tree here, we've got one of those nice headstones. Check out the size of that in 12th scale. Awesome detail, begging for black washing and dry brushing. We got the back of his cape here. His suit jacket, his tux jacket. We got two parts to a nice stinky rat. We got a skull. We saw the back of that. We've got his pantaloons. You can see in 12th scale. They're a little bit longer than my chubby fingers. So you get an idea of the size of these. They're not tiny. Easy to paint because of their size. We have nice detail on the front of the suit. With his necklace, his bow tie. Pantaloons and suit all in one piece in the front. Check out his creepy looking face. Oh, with his teeth. Back of his skull. We got his hands. We got his chain that holds his cape on. We got part of his cape here. We've got arms on either side for the motion. Remember, he's going to flap his arms like a bird. There's not a massive amount of plastic in the kit. We got the graveyard scene. We got the nice mound over the one grave. We have the base for the huge headstone. This guy had more money than this guy did. So that's all set up there. We got the giant motion headstone. The head will fall off when his arms fly up. Beautiful engraving. 1710. Ratzloff. And the back of that carved headstone. These are just begging to be done up in different materials. Go to the other side of the table. We've got a plastic garbage bag style plastic material. That's for his cape so that it can move and be free when his arms move. And we have a rubber band, which is what activates the motion on the kit like all of them. So I'm going to start assembling it, planning out my painting and build, and I'll be right back. Total assembly time to get what you see here before I want to paint is about 90 minutes at most, waiting for glue to dry and stuff like that. All the parts glow. I will show some steps of these figure kit assemblies in the next montage for the painting area, just so you can see how the rubber band will route and how the arm should be to make them work for you. Now we've got it just loosely put together, and just touching it may set it off because this plastic is extremely slippery with no paint on it. Everything has like a hair trigger to it. But his arms, when you hit the button on the back, are supposed to fly up and knock this figurehead off. Now, I don't think I have him lined up the right way. He's not glued in. I just used some poster putty to hold him down. I left the cape separate because I want to be able to paint that completely separate from the figure. The collar around his neck is just pressed on. His head is just gently pressed in. So let's take those off. I'm going to set the whole thing off here. Okay. So we got the collar on there. You saw how it looks. That is goes on there nice. I want to paint those separately. We got his head glued together. I'll be painting that and then gluing it on at the end so I can get that all detailed away from the clothing and the body. We've got the nice little additional skull. You can use it, not use it, whatever you want. We got the cool little rat accessory. Love that little guy, rats in cemeteries. I've got the cape cut out of that plastic with the center for the switch. Now, they want you to glue it onto his arms later. I'm going to use double-sided tape. I trust that more than trying to get glue over paint and all the other details on his thing. We've got the headstone here. Well, let's set it off first, then we'll take the other things apart, okay? So, there's a switch on the back that we'll see in a moment. And you just activate it, and his arms go flying up. If you push it all the way, they both go up at the same time. That knocks the goat's head off the headstone. So that's there, and you can see how that all works. Now we can pull that big headstone off. You can see how that assembles. Look at the size of that thing. It is so cool looking. So we get to paint that separately. We got this little headstone over here that I stuck down with poster putty to hold it in before I glue it in. We get to paint that separately and weather it up and detail it. And we have the vampire. I just used this poster putty to hold them in place before I glue them. You can see that cool switch on the back. The arms press down, you press that switch, and they go flying up for you when he flaps his cape like that. And that's an excellent figure too. You can see hardly any seams that wouldn't be where clothing is to begin with. So I'm not, I mean, I don't worry about seams to begin with, but honestly, so what, right? Looks great. Now, if you want to remove all those seams, you go right ahead. But there were clothing seams would be anyways. I'm gonna leave him. He's a nice size figure, so I can start getting things painted up like the base here with its grass tones and its dirt tones. We'll take the poster putty out of there before we do it. So what I'm gonna do is go over to the paint area now. There'll be a quick slideshow in the beginning to show you how some of the figure assembly goes and how cool these parts glow, how brightly they glow when you get light on them for a few minutes, and then we'll be right back. Thank you.
Thank you.
Once you see all the cool ways you can personalize your own figure kits is when you really get into enjoying building them. Now, I've got the vampire done here. I did them with very pale eyes. This is called a jeweler's vise, by the way. I have them on there so I could decorate him. I did some blood underneath his lips, his teeth, used some shaders around his eyes, and then pretty much just left him in that very pale coloration without a lot of detailing on there. I used Archer Transfer eyes. You can just pick these up anywhere. Order them, whatever you want. They don't come with the kit. Makes the eye work a little easier. And then I put drops of Mod Podge gloss where the eyeballs were. I'm not going to do a tutorial on model faces because I am not the person to take lessons from. I just like painting my models up and enjoying them that way. So he's ready to go. The body is all set. Now I'm not going to weather or beat this up at all. That I want to look. Vampires are already pretty dapper when they have this look to them. So we'll end up putting the arms down like so. You can see they'll go up when you press that switch. You know, we're going to have him with his animation, and then he'll put it up with his cape. The cape I need to tape to the back. Now, they want you to glue it. I'm just going to use some inexpensive black foam double-sided tape, which I know will hold a lot better than trying to put glue on that plastic. We'll put some tape over here. We'll put some tape over here, and we'll put some tape right on the back. Then we will put the top of his cape over it. We'll put the collar of the cape on there. We'll glue the front of the cape with its gold clasp across the front. Then we'll glue that head on there, glue him to the base, and he's all ready for his motion. The base looks awesome. I added some details that aren't there because that's what modeling, you can do that. Added some tall grass for the courtesy of a cheap paintbrush. Added some scattered dirt over the newer headstone. We can see this one's 1710, this one's 1871. I got the skull there. He's been harvesting victims, bringing them back to life. We don't know what date this is, but it looks awesome. Added some moss, some grass effects like we showed. You can even decorate, you know, the back of the stones, do that to them. Leave them set up like so. Do whatever you want with your base. You put them on there, get him in there so that his arm will knock off that headstone when he opens it up, and the flight of the vampire, it's going to look so cool. So a really quick, easy build. These figure kits, there's not a lot of parts to them, so you can have a lot of fun, decorate as you wish. And if you want to build it right out of the box without adding all the accoutrement like I like to do, you go right ahead. So we got Mr. Rat up here, glued in place and all that stuff. I'm going to finish putting him together, get him on the base. We'll come back for that final. I absolutely love these quirky figure kits from Polar Lights via Round 2. Thanks for the peeps over at Round 2 for sending this one over for review. As always, I love building them up. You can see the back of the figure. He is sprung and loaded. And surprisingly, that cape looks really nice. I thought being made out of that thin plastic garbage bag material, it might not be as nice, but it actually looks really good back there. It doesn't look fakey or too toyish or anything. His red cape goes over the top to hold it into place. It's glued with that double-sided tape to his arms and one to his back of his back there. We've got the nice head glued on. I use super glue to attach everything else. We've got our skull. We've got the gravestones, which are awesome. We got that rat accessory. And when you get yours, you can add even more stuff than I did. I just wanted to make it look a little more creepy, a little less barren on that plastic, of course. And I wanted to add a little bit. And this is a total combined value of about 75 cents worth of ground cover, paintbrush fronds, and some liquid glue diluted way down. So when he comes around, we're going to set him off by pushing that trigger you see on his back. He's supposed to send that head just a flying. If we push on it, we should get both to come up. If I would have pushed on it a little faster, they both come up at the exact same time. But now he's got his arms stretched out like that. The cape looks awesome. We'll see it coming back around. And you can reset that and use it as many times as you want. These are nothing but fun. So if you only want to model cars or you only want to model military, give a figure kit a try and have some fun with it and enjoy yourself a little bit. These are so much fun. You pick a couple of these up, give them to the kids for Halloween. Let them build the dungeon. Let them build the vampire. Let them build the grave robber and display them every Halloween when it comes around and put them out and have a really nice time. Or, you know, you can give the kids, these are so simple. You can give the younger kids, you know, I'd say, you know, 10 and up, You can give them one of these. You can go assemble the more complicated ones or a pirate kit, and they can put these together and let them glow. And then you can go ahead and paint it up like I did and do it that way. There's all different kinds of ways to have fun with a model kit, and that's what I always want to stress on this channel. It doesn't matter the colors that I've chosen. It doesn't matter how I chose to paint it. All I want you to see is what could be done with the kit when you buy yours, and then you need to build it for you. And you need to have fun with the model kits that you spend your hard-earned money on, because that's what the hobby is about. Don't build for me. Don't build for anyone else out there in internet land. Build for you, and make sure you smile when you're all done. I had a lot of fun building this. There will be links in the description where you can pick up your own copy, and we will see all of you at the next review.